It is interesting to note that in the farewell discourse of Jesus, or during his last supper with his disciples, he speaks of the Holy Spirit three times. In John chapter 14, verse 15, Jesus states that the Holy Spirit will be sent by the Father as an advocate or consoler. In John chapter 14, verse 26, Jesus promises that he himself, on behalf of his Father, will send the Spirit of truth, who will teach them all things. And in John chapter 16, verses 1 to 15, Jesus reveals the Father's plan of salvation, along with the announcement that the fruit of his ascension into heaven will be the sending of the Holy Spirit. In this reflection, let us focus on the first reference. When the Advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will bear witness about me. These words bring to mind not only the procession of the Holy Spirit from the Father and the Son, but also the special role of the Holy Spirit in the life of the Church and in our Christian life, in our personal life. In the light of this text, we perceive the mission of the Holy Spirit, which is to console the disciples, to defend them, and to bear witness about Jesus. How do we understand the Greek word parakletos? Although the word is filled with a complex meaning, Bible scholars and philologists suggest that it is a verbal adjective. It is often used of one called into a law court to speak in favor of a person or a cause. In the Jewish tradition, the word parakletos was used when referring to angels, prophets, and the just as advocates before God's court. Here it can be said that prior to his passion and death, Jesus consoles his disciples through a promise. His disciples would never be abandoned in a state of despair and fear. The Holy Spirit will be their consoler. The Holy Spirit will be their guide and defender. As can be perceived in the Acts of the Apostles, and in the letters of St. Paul, we notice that the Holy Spirit consoled the first disciples of Jesus by empowering them in their mission of evangelization despite the persecutions that they had to go through. In Romans chapter 15, verse 13, St. Paul would succinctly remark that they who follow Jesus overflowed with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Ingana ang impact sa Espiritu Santo sa kinabuhi sa unang mga Kristiyanos. And hopefully, ato ning marediscover, because according to St. Jose Maria Escriva, the Holy Spirit is the great unknown. We seldom talk about the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit is sent to us from the Father through the Son, that we may be empowered, that we may imitate the Lord, that we may persevere in doing our mission in life. My dear friends, how do we experience the action of the Holy Spirit? How do we perceive His consoling presence in our lives? Whenever we experience doubts, confusions, whenever we feel despair and fear, do we invoke the Holy Spirit, asking for His guidance, for His strength? Whenever we find it difficult to forgive another person, do we invoke Him that we may truly find meaning in forgiving this particular person? When we become too selfish to think only of ourselves, do we ask the Holy Spirit for the grace that we may be an instrument of God's charity? every day of our lives, we need to constantly invoke the Holy Spirit. One day, I had a long conversation with a fellow priest who was hospitalized for 2 weeks. He became infected after cutting his head while doing some small renovations in his parish. He thought it was just an ordinary wound. All seemed fine until 2 days later, when he was unable to open his mouth due to locked jaw and severe fever. It took some time before the ambulance arrived at the far-flung barrio where he was assigned. He started to feel an intense fear and hopelessness. But during those moments, there was one song that came to his mind. Come, Holy Spirit, I need you. Come, sweet Spirit, I pray. Come in your strength and your power. Come in your own gentle way. Muni ang gibalik-balik og kanta. Samtang conscious pa siya, matud pa ni ining pari. According to him, at first he thought that he would not survive the ordeal. But when he sincerely invoked the Holy Spirit, he was consoled by God's abiding presence. Today, he continues to recall not only the fact that he almost died from tetanus, but his beautiful encounter with the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, the Consoler. As we continue to offer this Holy Mass, as we continue to face this global pandemic, as we deal with the inevitable ups and downs in life, may we always experience the consoling presence of the third person of the Holy Trinity, the Holy Spirit, our Consoler. Amen.